definitely like to include a campaign of some sort. It remains yet to be seen. We don't know what happened in March yet.
As for the deliveries, there is a process plan for the deliveries, as per usual.
As the taxi out here, you will demonstrate the extreme maneuverability of the Corsair on the deck of the carrier.
The landing gear of the Corsair and the ability to sustain the hard deck hit and tight turns, as you can see here. And one deck was the task was finished and successfully completed, it allowed us to move to other systems of development, including the engine and the quite mighty class, which served more than air brakes that the other class is doing more than 50 degrees.
Now, as you're taxiing down the ramp here, before departure, the damage model, the engine, what kind of tricks do you have up your sleeves with the addition of the new damage models with EDs working on?
Well, the cargo.
Okay, go on.
Well, the current plan is to basically develop along with the Eagle Dynamics project for the damage model. They are, as far as I know, they are preparing to release it at some point, and our intention is to keep exactly to those standards, but at this specific time it's hard to tell which exact parts or items may be damageable.
Now, Novak, do you want to take us through what you're about to do here with the Corsair?
This should demonstrate the stability of the engine flight module. I will engage the front brace and pivot around them as I engage the front to demonstrate the stability of the airstream module of the key and possibility to precisely control the aircraft in such situations.
Until we can take off, it is there, guys. I can tell you, congratulations on a lot of people looking forward to this. Now, can you elaborate a little bit on the exact model we're looking at for this Corsair?
We're especially looking at those new airframes that are built currently after August of 44, or any build numbers of 82,300-ish and 76.
Very, very, very cool. Without some, can you explain to me some of the other uniqueness that
comes with this specific airframe? Yes, this is the late Corsair, which obviously has extended ground attack capabilities. You could say that 1D model was more of a fighter bomber than the predecessors. It obviously included water injection, which improved the performance on the so-called combat rating power, and aircraft also had improved rocket capabilities as the introduction of the HDAR and later on IDT rockets was possible.
Very cool, and of course we're seeing right over the top there, put it back on the down line there, tiny rockets. So that will, what we're seeing will be available.
Yes, sir. All the way from the launch.
Can you elaborate against, just real quick, on the damage model of the engine? A lot of us have seen some of the other modules as far as the frost and how we can overheat it easily and things like that. What we have to work with this particular model as far as the engine?
system such as the engine itself. And then we will try to simulate what will happen if the particular system is going to.
And so I'll ask maybe the big elephant room question out there. Is there, this thing is carrier capable, is that correct? Or will it be modeled hopefully in the future with maybe a little throwback carrier or the current carrier?
Carrier capable, it's in line with any carrier available in DCS at the moment, including the one we've seen this video.
Oh, very exciting. Go ahead, Grinelli, I'm going to take your space. What do you got, sir?
Right now, we're preparing numbers about to show us a demonstration of the flight model and the stall characteristics of the Corsair.
Yeah, it's going to be one of my questions to ask was the stall characteristics. I remember a very famous training video of the Corsair, beautiful airplane.
Yeah, so with that, what are we expecting on these stalls? Is it mild buffet? Is it something different? What kind of characteristics does this aircraft present?
Well, as you know, the Corsair had a big engine and very big prop. Prop had a reduced number of rotation in relation to the engine with the gear 2-to-1. But basically, as you can see, the aircraft always, if the engine is working, the car is rotating the aircraft will always stall to the left side. And that's the smaller road, using natural forces, nothing is scripted there, and you can see it turning. And it will also dynamically stall with G's and everything. Pretty much, the flight model is basically based on experiences from the Christian Eagle 2 and also improved.
That is one fast aircraft, as well, from what I understand. It is actually one of the fastest as far as original aircraft out of the factory. Am I wrong?
Well, that was the urban myth, so to say. It was fast, but not as fast as it was the first one that flew over 400 miles, because actually the Mustang is faster than Corsair, but still Corsair is very, very fast, and he has an excellent climbing rate.
Of course, we love those dipped wings, right?
Yeah.
The wings that allow it the landing gear to be shorter and sort of that, you know, that prop to clear, as well as to store on the carrier deck as he goes down into the vertical. That's pretty cool.
Well, as you can see here, is basically Corsair landing on 90 degrees down with the, so to say, air brakes out. Corsair, as you know, didn't have the air brakes, but the front gears were used for the air braking, actually. The pilot had a special button to use the front gears of the brake.
And then, of course, this has a very powerful engine. Can you tell us, besides the damage model, as it goes in for some, looks like some ground attack, anything special about how to start this aircraft up or anything like that? Yeah, and I'll elaborate. Is there any, I imagine we're looking at it basically how you start up a Corsair is how you will, this will function in the DCS, am I correct?
It will function as you can see here, and kind of video explaining the Corsair startup. Basically, you have to flip fuel switches and bring the fuel to the engine, prime the engine. If you ever start with EF51 or P51, it's pretty similar. Complete internal engine process is similar to that. It's very, very simple. Those were very simple plans when it comes to avionics, you know, Second World War.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I'll ask this too. What state will the module be released in as far as systems and flight mode?
We're not going to release anything that is not done, you know. But as usual, only the users and the large number of users can really got proper feedback about the aircraft. Because we can't possibly test every possible situation there. But we will release a feature complete and completely functional and stable model.
So you can also expect the external lights and the prop tanks to be fully operational.
Okay, I'm reading between the lines there, Roger. That got it. That's exciting. Well,
what kind of bomb
can
we expect?
High stator.
Anything up to 1,000 pound bombs?
Nice.
So
yeah,
obviously that supreme flight skill there.
I love how he balances it so well. So, and this is really cool because. And many other modules, that's hard to do, and I'm curious to see how. Is that easy to do relatively, or is that still a very challenging thing that they're doing on that controller?
Well, it requires some skills, basically, but, you know, guys like 60 or 70 years ago did it, so basically, this is what flight model provides, it was one of the requirements. DCS courses have to do the same things as the real one. And real one was basically landing on the wheels or at two points, whatever you want. And it was very stable there, and it can take off and go for another pass or whatever from two wheels.
Now, I gotta ask as well, because the F4U was primarily used in World War II in the Pacific Theater. Its opponent was, well, many opponents, what was the zero? Are we expecting anything like that maybe in the near future too? Okay, well, we'll look at that. Very cool.
We have the plans for enemy fighter aircraft. We're still deciding on what we'd like to actually battle for the opponent.
Right, well, I tell you what, we're going to transition now to this, Ian. Look at that beautiful ship right there. Can you tell us about that?
Well, it's a USS Essex class carrier. I believe there are two versions, a long haul and a short haul. The 1.5 model was the long haul, which is, oh my gosh, I think there are 24 carriers that were under the Essex class. So we're going to try to include a bunch of liveries for it as well.
That's exciting. Any support ships on that, or are we just looking at the carrier at this time?
Just the carrier.
Very cool. I know we already have some support ships, at least one or two in UCS, so that'd be cool to put those next to it. But super cool. We talked about it landing on the carrier. You said it does that. So I guess that's what we're seeing right now. This is exciting.
Now the best part is you have more than four wires to get on the boat.
Yeah, just don't be that guy in front, though, right? Stuck if you got to do a go around it.
I bet nobody gets the three wire every time.
Back to Granelli?
Yes, of course. The USS Essex itself is the only one that did not have catapults, but every other one did.
Now, just as much as getting off the boat, it's getting back on. The Essex was not equipped with the modern instruments that we're so used to now, it's spoiled with. Can we expect to see a LSO flapping his arms on the deck of his boat?
It's definitely something we'd like to do. I think we're going to try to use maybe the current Eiffel's argument system and try to use those numbers to drive the arms and the paddles of the boss there.
That's a wonderful thing. We'll definitely be looking forward to trying to see if that's a thing. Because that will be glorious.
I can't wait to see the wave off.
I hope it doesn't fall off the ship like a hot shot, right?
As Nomad makes his final approach again on the deck of the boat, is there anything the crew would like to add
new hotness I see right now in many ways. So, we'll leave the floor to you here.
Thank you. Thank you for the invite. Everyone who's watching, thank you for the support over the years. It's been a long haul, but we're managing, and we'll hope to bring this aircraft to you as soon as possible.
Presentation, F4U Corsair.